We were told you grow corn and beans in Iowa. You don't grow lavender. Here we are, 8 years later, and we're still growing lavender, so I think we're proving them wrong. I'm Mary Hamer. My husband Tim and I are owners of the Les Hills Lavender Farm. We started our little farm in 2009, and it's been quite an experience. A lot of ups and downs, and good and bad. Tim and I both grew up here in the Les Hills and went to high school together. We're high school sweethearts. We always knew we wanted to come back to the hills, and this is where we wanted to grow the lavender. Right away, I had to decide if it was going to work. And so we actually came over and got buckets of Les Hills soil. And the best way to learn how to grow lavender is to kill it, and we did. We had some live, and they really liked that Les Hills soil. So we kept looking, and it took us 4 years to find the farm. It all just seemed to fall into place. People think it's just a little flower. It's been used for centuries to clean wounds. It's used for relaxation, insomnia, as well as it's a great deterrent for many bugs that we don't like. You can do everything from clean lice out of hair to make cookies with it. That's a pretty amazing little herb. We always thought that the farm would be someplace where people could come, cut their own bouquets. That was the beginning of it. And also possibly even a place where it would grow enough that I could hire some of the local women. I feel it's so important to empower other women to have that opportunity to give women an outlet. We'd love to have people come because when they leave, we want them to feel like they have really experienced something special, that they feel better for their day after being here. To anybody that comes here, I really don't care if they spend a dime, but I want them to walk away with a smile and a feeling of peace, because it's hard to find. Love these hills. I think the dirt gets in your soul and in your blood, and you just have to come back to them.